Now let's jump in another topic, which is arcing ground. So arcing ground, we can say, is one of the cause of high voltage surge in a power system. This we can say a ground fault on one of the phase of a underground cable, which is not neutral, is not grounded in that kind of power system. So let us consider this simple underground cable system where three phase system R, Y, B, and the neutral is N, which is not grounded. And actually this is the healthy condition. So there will be some charging current in a transmission line. So let's say the charging current flow in this phase is IB, charging current here it is IY, charging current here it is IR. Okay, now this is a balanced power system, balanced three phase circuit. That is why the voltage VR, VY and VB are displaced by 120 degree with each other. The current IR leading the voltage by 90 degree, because here charging current is capacitive in nature. So that is why the current will lead voltage by 90 degree. So we can say IR lead voltage VR by 90 degree. Same way IY and IB leading VI and VB by 90 degree. So here it is, we are assuming that is a healthy condition. That is why the IR plus IY plus IB is equal to zero. And the voltage at the neutral will be zero also. Now take in mind that neutral is not grounded. Now let's say the line to ground fault occur at any one phase. Let's say the B phase is now faulty phase. So the line to ground fault occurs at this point. So in this condition also the charging current will flow from the R phase and from the Y phase, and that current is IY and IR. That is flow from phase to ground, that is IVAR, IR plus IY. Now C is faulty phase, that is why the IC current, the charging current will not flow any longer. But now both this faulty phase and also this charging current is flowing to the ground are connected through the ground. That is why this IR plus IV, IY is going to flow from this healthy phase to this faulty phase. So if you just apply the KCL right here, then IC is equal to nothing but IR plus IY, and the direction of current is also reversed. Here you can see the direction of current IR, IY and IB in this direction. Here also the healthy phase, in healthy phase the direction of current will be this only, but in faulty phase the direction of current will be opposite. Now initially the voltage at neutral is zero, but now due to the fault, line to ground fault occur in a underground cable which is neutral is not grounded, and that is why now the voltage at neutral is no longer zero. So VN is not equal to zero, but VN is actually the voltage at this phase. Let's say the voltage is phase is VB. So VN is now, it is not zero, but it is now VN is equal to VB. Okay, this is easily understandable. So if you want to find the voltage at let's say RN, if you want to find voltage V is equal to voltage VRN, then it will be VR minus VB. Okay, or rather we can say the phase voltage will become is equal to the line voltage. So in that case the phase will become line voltage, and which is 3 root 3 times the normal phase voltage, and the magnitude of the voltage will become root 3 times. That's actually due to the the arcing ground, and that is why it is very dangerous for insulation and it may break down. So let us draw the vector diagram for this condition. So let's say this is VR, VY and VB in healthy phase condition. Now if you want to draw VRN, which is VR minus VB, so this is VR, this is VB, so do the vector sum and it will give us this VRB. Same way you can find VYB. Okay, now the charging current in this phase will be 90 degree leading, so here it is VY. Charging current in this phase VYB is also 90 degree leading, so it is VY. Okay, it is actually IR and IY. I have made a mistake, it is IR. So just correct right here, it is IR and here it is IB. Okay, so here we have seen that IC is equal to IR plus IB. Okay, so if you want to find IB, here it is IB, then you have to find the vector sum of IR and IY. If you do so, then you will get I in a faulted phase is equal to vector sum of VR and VI. That will become this. The blue marker will show the faulted current in a due to the arcing ground, and that the magnitude of this is root 3 time of IA, or we can say the root 3 time of IB. Now also the value of IA and IB will become root 3 times, so the value of ICA will become 3 times the normal healthy current. Okay, so that is why this is important for you. So in case of arcing ground, here the voltage will become root 3 times and the current will become 3 times, and this is dangerous for our insulation of the equipment, whether it is a transmission line or insulators, or we can say any end equipments connected at the substation. So arcing ground this is the basic fundamentals of the arcing ground. Now let us discuss another example, or we can say the condition of transient due to the, we can say, the internal causes. Okay, so it is one of the hazardous condition occur in a power system when any capacitor bank connected in a transmission line is disconnected. So consider a given figure right here. Now L is a source inductance connected in series with E. C is nothing but a capacitor bank connected to the power system through a switch S. Now let us consider that the switch S is interrupted and the capacitance current at instant is A. Let's say this is capacitor current and the switch is interrupted at time t is equal to, let's say it is A. So at that time the switch is interrupted, and that is why at this instance the capacitor is charged to its maximum value. So if you just click this on, the capacitor will charge at its maximum value and it will be EM only. Okay, so as the capacitor is isolated from the source, it's retain the its charge obviously, and now the at instant B, let's say this instant, we are talking about this instant now, or we can say the half cycle later, the voltage across the switch reaches the peak value of 2 times EM, and the voltage reignite the arc and cause oscillatory transient. So the if you want to find now the value of voltage across the capacitance, then it will become the voltage across the capacitor, it is the initial voltage across the capacitor, which is EM, plus the higher frequency transient voltage, which is given by 2 EM 1 minus cos t and divided by root LC. So now this can increase the maximum value of the voltage which is minus 3 EM, as shown in the figure. You can see right here the maximum peak value is 3 EM. If you just ignore this sign, the peak value is 3 EM in the downward direction, or you can say in negative cycle. So the interruption of a circuit or a second restart can cause still a higher voltage. So whenever you are going to switch on or switch off this which is connected to a capacitor bank, then the value of voltage will become very higher. This is nothing but a voltage surge in a power system whenever you are switching on and off this capacitor bank. So this is one of the hazardous condition occurred in a power system when a capacitor bank connected to a transmission line is disconnected. Okay, so this is all about transient due to the switching transient, or we can say also understand the external causes due to the lightning.